In LaGrange, the recovery effort continued today with two well-known barbecue restaurants in town filling a need by filling plates. While hot meals make a difference, sustaining the recovery effort does remain a concern. Fox 7's Rudy Koski joins us in studio with more on that tonight.
Hi, Rebecca. The barbecue teams are from Taylor and Elgin, towns just like LaGrange. Small, but with big hearts. And today, they were serving up more than just brisket.
One meal at a time. That's how the recovery is progressing in LaGrange. Monday morning, two barbecue icons, Southside and Louis Miller, set up shop. Pounds of brisket and ribs were sliced, replaced by even more meat, smoked for blood victims and volunteers. Pitmaster Wayne Miller told me this Labor Day, labor of love, serves as a reminder that the need is not limited just to Houston.
We're here to show our support for our kindred spirit here in LaGrange and all up and down the Colorado, really. There's just spotted of all sorts of small communities that need help. And anything that anybody can do to go help those folks, I think, you know, so it's incumbent upon us to do it, because if we don't do it, who is?
The Southside team has served three meals a day since Friday. That's a little more than 5,000 meals so far. Owner Brian Bracewell understands what a hot meal means right now.
You know, ironically, today is 6 years removed from the wildfire. And so 6 years ago today, my wife and I lost our house in the Bastrop wildfire. And, you know, we received so much help, so many blessings during that period of time in our lives that when this happened, we knew that we needed to be here.
Craig Waddell, who had his home swept away a week ago, was among those who walked away Monday with a warm meal and some hope.
This town is something else. It's something else, you know. It's probably on every corner some kind of food. So, one thing we don't have to worry about, our bellies.
Filling the need by filling plates brought volunteers like Izzy Eidelman. He came from New York.
Yeah, it's just pretty cool. We just arrived at 3 a.m. last night, so we're still a bit out of it today.
Working the food line for Jim Heinz and his wife Shannon meant more than just giving up a holiday in Cedar Creek. It's also their wedding anniversary.
Been out delivering breakfast this morning to people that are trying to get their lives and their house back together, and it's just a small difference that it makes.
Another example of it's not the size, but the effort, was Caden Lynn. He's in charge of dispensing sauce.
I'd rather do this than my homework.
The recovery effort really got going late last week. I'm told since Thursday, about 500 families have received donations from this distribution location. Things like new shoes, of course, clothing, even underwear and clean socks. But organizers tell me that they are suspending this kind of donation effort right now, but they still need help.
We have an additional warehouse next door that is absolutely packed to the brim.
Linda Morrison is with the community thrift shop Secondhand Emporium, which was also lost in the flood. As she and others process what's been given, they still need financial help and replacements for the army of volunteers working now.
Tomorrow starts school back in LaGrange. We're going to lose a lot of our student workers and helpers and our teacher base too. So there will be a lot of volunteer opportunities as far as sorting and helping us restock this distribution building, things like that.
Addressing the need is expected to last for months.
A lot of great people there in LaGrange. Financial donations can be made through a special website called LG Relief. That's LaGrange Relief, LGRelief.com. Now, the distribution center, I'm told, is expected to stay open for the rest of this month. Sometime in October, the plan is to reopen that thrift store. Rebecca.